year we focused on the industrial culture that was here for maybe 100 years. And next year we'll be dealing more with how we can help heal some of the damage from that industrial culture.
In an effort to raise awareness and support the movement to clean up the area, the Sophia Academy 8th grade class 2012 has designed this floating sculpture. Gorham Factory Production near Metro Pond in Providence, Rhode Island has left the land and water where operated diseases with toxins and poisons. It's been years since the Gorham Factory has been in business next to the pond, but damage has been left behind. The land and water are toxic and unhealthy. People are prohibited from swimming in or drinking from the water where the fish suffer from disease. A school was built on the former Gorham site right next to the pond. It was necessary to build a special air filtration system beneath the school to ensure that the air quality is safe for students, staff, and teachers. As part of our art and science curriculum, we twisted wire sculptures, drew sketches, and molded clay to come up with a final model. Our sketches and ideas were realized in collaboration with artists at Providence Steel Yard.
The sculpture is made of steel, oil paint, plexiglass, and recycled materials. The sculpture carries dying, diseased flowers on one side to represent Macfog's industrial past, and holds healthy, bright flowers on the other to show the pond's future. On the top of the sculpture sits a piece of hollowware to represent the Gorham Factory. The theme of the sculpture is simply the progression from the past to the future. Our goal is to have people recognize and appreciate our work while learning more about the pond and its history.
Thank you.